Hi, I'm Eric.
Hi, I'm Carrie.
And this video is all about Steam game recording. I'm going to start off with a quick overview of this new Steam feature, and then Carrie here is going to walk you through a real-world example of integrating a game with the Steam Timeline API using Left 4 Dead and actual code samples. Let's jump right into it. First, a quick high-level overview of Steam game recording, a new system we've built into Steam. With Steam game recording, users can automatically record their gameplay sessions, review replays, and clip and share their favorite moments. The gameplay recording happens in the background, automatically and seamlessly, regardless of whether you're playing on a desktop, laptop, or Steam Deck. There's no doubt that players will use game recording to clip and share their weirdest, coolest, and most memeable moments with their friends and the world. But we also think there are a whole lot of other uses for the feature. You might pull up a game recording to go back and rewatch a conversation with an NPC to hear what they told you to do, or to see how you died in a multiplayer match. Game developers might use it to find and reproduce an elusive bug. We're excited to see all the cool uses players and developers discover with Steam game recording. As a developer, you can decide what makes sense for your game. You don't need to do anything special with your game to make game recording work, as long as your game supports Steam overlay. The game recording works automatically. Steam Timeline enhances the experience in a big way. What is Steam Timeline? It's a way for developers to create timeline markers that help users find their best, most shareable gameplay moments, because these moments are marked right on the timeline of their gameplay session. For a user, it's as easy as clicking on customizable icons that mark important or exciting gameplay moments, then they are taken directly to a shareable clip of that moment. Enabling Steam Timeline is as easy as adding some simple API calls to your game and uploading some icons into Steamworks. Uploading icons is as easy as adding achievements. Okay, that's the overview, but now I'll hand it over to Carrie to show you an actual example of adding some easy, lightweight API calls to your game so it supports Steam Timeline.
Thanks, Eric. So we're going to go ahead and do a demo in Left 4 Dead 2 today. If you're not familiar with Left 4 Dead 2, this is a co-op zombie apocalypse shooter. It's the kind of game that can get very chaotic, and there are moments that you would often want to be able to share with your friends. And so this is a perfect example of looking for events that we can mark up and make available to customers if they want to look back through their game session and have things that they can show and share and brag about or laugh about. So on the right side, I've got iSteam Timeline header open. This is really all the documentation that you need to use this interface. So I'm just going to keep it open there for reference. And then on the left is where we're going to be entering our code. Steam fortunately has a game event messaging system. So we're going to choose particular interesting events during gameplay that we want to respond to and mark up in our recording. And then we can just add all of the code right here and keep it nice and simple. So I have my LSteam video singleton. All of this is pretty much boilerplate. We don't have to do any special initialization of Steam Timeline. We just access the interface and make sure the interface is there in case somebody has an older version running. And then on shutdown, we're going to stop listening for game events. And then fire game event is where all the action happens. The events come in and we will start making our calls. So the first thing we're going to do is look at setting the game mode in the timeline. This will change the way the timeline appears when you're looking at it, so you can get an overview of changes in game state. And we're going to use survival mode today because that has really clear start and endpoints. So we'll listen for survival round start, and then we will also want the round end. So now I've registered to listen to these game events, and all we have to do is in fire game event, we will respond to these. So first of all, we'll listen to the survival round start event. And now we just have to make a single call. Steam Timeline. And we'll set the game mode. And we're gonna set that to game mode playing. I didn't point out up here, when we first initialized, we set the time Lemgade mode to staging by default. These names are there just for reference, but you can use them in whatever way best suits your game. So we're going to say that staging is before the survival round is started, and then playing is once the round has actually started. And so we've got the start round handled, and now we're just going to do the round end. And for this one, we will go back to the staging. So that's all we have to do. We've got our round start and our round end, and we will go ahead and launch the game, and then we can run a quick survival round and see what that looks like in the timeline.
We might
first
need to
aid, last to die.
So we'll run down quickly, hit the radio to start the survival round. All right, so now we should have changed game state to playing.
Incoming!
And I have a way to end this quickly by just launching myself off the building. And there, we had a 14-second round. So now if I go look at the timeline, you'll be able to see that here was the setup. This is where I hit the radio. And the round started, and so the timeline display changes, and then the round ended, and we go back to the staging timeline. So this is a way for players to be able to find the changes in state in the game as they're playing. All right, well, that worked well, so let's go on to the next thing. So now we've changed the game state. Now we're going to add some event markers so that people can actually see when special events happen. And to do that, we're going to add one for healing. Players don't have many opportunities to heal, so this might be something that you want to find in your game session. So we're going to add the game event, Heal Success. And then we will just go ahead and add a handler for that. And for this one, we are going to make an add timeline event call. This one has a few more parameters. We're going to start with the icon name, which is MedKit32. I uploaded that to the partner site earlier. Give it a title of healed. For the description, we are going to we're going to put the amount that you healed, just for fun. Restored health, and that comes in the event. Then we have the priority, which we won't worry about right now. For this particular event in Left 4 Dead, healing takes a period of time. It takes about 5 seconds to heal. And we know that the heal success event is going to come in at the end of that 5 seconds. So for this example, we'll say that the full 5 seconds is the duration of the clip of the event that we want to highlight. So we're going to put the start time at 5 seconds in the past, and the duration will be 5 seconds. And then we'll make the priority standard. And that should be it. So let's run the game and take a look at this.
This first aid will help.
Pills here!
So I have a shortcut here to hurt myself. And I need to stop the bots from healing me. Alright, now I execute the healing event. And when we check the timeline, you can see there's my icon that says that's when I healed. And it says healed, restored 60 health. And then you see here it shows this event has a 5 second duration. So if I select it as a clip, it's going to show a full healing progress. And it highlights it here on the timeline so that if I want to save this to my recordings, I come out with exact healing duration. And then I can share this, upload it to social media, send it to my friends. All right, that worked well. Let's create one more event as an example. Something a little more dramatic this time. We're going to do when the player gets incapacitated. So in Left 4 Dead, if you take too much damage, you fall to the ground and you can't get up again unless one of your teammates comes and helps you. So this is typically happening at a very chaotic part of the game. It could be a lot of action and probably is a good moment that you might want to share with your friends. So we'll just create another event. We'll make this the player incapacitated start. I'm just going to put a placeholder string here because I haven't uploaded an icon for this one, but that's fine because Steam will provide a default one in the meantime. I can go back and upload one later if I want to. Incapacitated. And for this one, we are going to put who we were incapacitated by. Incapacitated by, which means we'll have to put a string in here. And we can pull that from the event with just a couple of lines. Player by user ID. And then we make our string. Get display. Oh, character. There we go, character display name. Now, obviously, I'm not doing any error checking here, but that's because I know exactly what data we have coming in, so I'm not concerned about it. For this one, we will go ahead and make it a bit higher priority. This really only matters if you have a lot of events happening at the same time and you want to know which ones should be prioritized in the display. And we will go ahead and just make this an instantaneous event, zero duration, zero start time, and that's because we're going to change the clip priority to featured. And that means because it's a featured clip, Steam will go ahead and add a small buffer of time to the beginning and the end of the event, before and after the event, so that if you make an automatic clip from that event, then you're going to get a chunk of time around it as well. And that should be all we have to do. Now we can just go ahead and run it.
First thing, I'm going to need these.
So in this case, I'm going to hurt myself again, and I have a key bound to spawn a tank, which is the toughest zombie character in the game. So he should be able to incapacitate me pretty quickly, if he decides to focus on me and not the other characters. One more hit. Look at that, they're too efficient. Let's bring another tank in. There we go. Now I've been incapacitated. So if we go back and look at the timeline, you'll see here's the default event marker because I didn't have an icon uploaded for this one. But you'll see that we have the incapacitated. It says incapacitated by tank. And this one is an instantaneous event, but because I gave it a priority, made it featured, is going to be a little bit of time before and after. Included in the thing. Now you can see it's already pre-selected. And so again, I can go ahead and save that, and then I can share it with my friends. So that's really all there is to it. You can just choose the moments in your game that you expect your customers would want to be looking back at, would want to share with their friends. And it's just a few simple calls to the Steam Timeline API, and everything else is handled for you automatically.
Carrie, how did you decide which events to put on the timeline?
Mainly from having played this game a bunch, you know the things that you talk about with your friends. Healing isn't as exciting, but typically when you're healing, it's because you're in a stressful situation and you need the health, so there's something exciting happening. But definitely deaths, incapacitations, major zombie kills. Those are all the things that you'd laugh about and you tell your friends about stories after the game. And so those are the type of things that we want to highlight so you can find them easily when you go back after you've played.
How long do you think it would take a developer to do a basic integration with the Steam Timeline API?
I think the longest time that it would take is just deciding what events you want to highlight. the actual implementation is just a matter of hours. I had set aside a day the first time I went to explore this, and within a half an hour, I already had several events entered in and realized that it was going to be much easier than I expected.
All right, I think that just about covers it for the Steam game recording feature and Steam Timeline API. Carrie, thank you so much for walking us through everything, and we're so excited to see what you do with it. Thanks for watching.